when I smoke. Boom, boom, boom. I absolutely love it. Bold tie.
Hey, what's going on, my YouTube family? Got a special guest coming on with me today. Want you guys to hold on while I wait on him to chime in. I got my friend, my brother, Mr. Bowtie himself from Bowtie Cigars. Y'all hold on. All right, people. Give me a second. We'll have Mr. Billy Bowtie on here with us for a nice interview in just a moment. What's up, YouTube? What's up, my cigar smoking family? I told y'all once, I told y'all twice, three, four, five times that real soon I was going to get my man on with me for an interview. I'm truly a man of my word. I did not lie. Who you see next to me on this screen call here is my man, my brother, my friend himself, Mr. Billy King, Mr. Bowtie himself, a Bowtie Cigar. Say hello to the people, Billy.
Cowboy, what's happening, bro? Good morning to you. Happy 2021.
Yeah, man.
I hope, you know, the best. I wish the best for you and your family for this upcoming year. And I just appreciate you having me on your show, bro. I must admit, at the end of the day, you know, when we're looking for things to try and make our life just a little bit better during all this craziness online, it's been cool to sink into your show, bro, and get your take on it. So thank you for that, bro. I really appreciate that a lot.
Hey, man, I appreciate you, man. You know, 2020 has been hell, man. I said in a video not long ago that it about drove me crazy. And cigars saved me, man. My love for cigars in the game and getting that YouTube channel started gave me something else to look forward to, man. Gave me something else to do. So thank you, man. The YouTube channel is doing more than I ever thought it would. I mean, you know, DG, shout out to my distinguished gentlemen brothers, man. My brothers, my real love. You see that plaque over there, man. DG for life, baby. You know, we was trying to start our little podcast thing, but COVID got in the way of that. So Cowboy decided to come on and just start doing some YouTube cigar videos, man. And it's been grand, man. The people have been loving it, man. So thank you for everything that you've done, man. I'm glad your cigars are out now and we can go ahead and start smoking these things, man.
Oh yeah, bro. It's been a hell of a ride.
Right.
2020, also, you know, just the cigars in general, since the beginning of this thing, has been a hell of a ride. And, you know, when you hear them say the journey, it's the journey. You got to appreciate it. The destination to be there when you get there, that's your vision. But if you got to enjoy that journey. And so I've learned that, and it's just been beautiful for me, bro. I'm fortunate. I'm blessed. And I'm happy to be sitting here with you again today, man. Oh, my goodness.
Hey, man, well, like I say, man, with you, patience was a virtue, man. You know, the Bible say you got the patience of Job, man, because when it looked like things wasn't going to go well for you in 2020 for the cigars because of shipping and COVID-19, you was like, hey, I'm cool. As long as my cigars are over there in the DR and they resting and they well, we just got to let things pass. When they come, they come. And it's probably the best thing to happen for Bowtie Cigars at that particular point in time, especially when we was waiting on this new line to come out.
Yeah, I've learned over time that so when I lived on the East Coast, shout out to anybody on the East Coast, man. Went to Howard University. You know, I'm a rep my. I don't know if you can see that HU alum.
That's
I'm
right.
A rep my.
I see. Yeah.
I'm a rep
yeah.
The East.
Yeah.
Mm. But when I went out there, a lot of cats that I met from the East Coast remind me of folks from the crib, from North Chicago, from Chicago area.
Mm-hmm.
And you ever heard them say you rush around to stand in line? Like you rush, 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 and then you go stand in line for a long time.
Right, right.
So in other words, you're rushing for nothing. Now, sometimes, you know, obviously rushing is necessary to try to get to some deadline. But when it comes down to creating a legacy, your deadline is you don't know what that is. Are you just trying to get it in while you're still walking around? I have had so many instances where things just didn't go the way they were the way I thought they should go. They took longer. Whether that was, you know, trying to find somebody to work with me to you know, being put out of business in a phone call. We'll talk about that a little bit. To whatever, it has given me patience. You know, you talked about Job. It's just giving me patience, man. So when COVID hit, I was like, this is unfortunate. But I do realize that at the end of the day, it's going to happen because it's supposed to. And, you know, I just took it. I just took the time, took the opportunity to do other stuff. And it's been wonderful. It's been wonderful.
You think about, man, how many times have you and I said to each other, man, we talk about organic all the time, man. Letting things happen organically, man. And, That's what happened this time, man. It happened the way it was supposed to happen. It's just like this YouTube channel, man. I ain't out here begging or asking for nothing. I just let that happen organically. I had no idea. But when you allow things to happen organically, man, you'd be surprised what the outcome is.
Absolutely. Shout out to you. Congratulations on the show, bro. You have been talking about doing your thing. And, you know, when you have a dream or vision, you're the only one that can see it in your head. You can try to explain it to somebody, but until they can see it, it's only real to you and your mind. And what you've done in such a short period of time, bruh, I salute you, man. I'm just proud of you, bruh.
It's been fun more than anything, man. You know what I mean? I don't want it to be work, but it truly has been fun, man. But I tell you what, man, they hear enough about Cowboy, man. We ain't on here to talk too much more about me. We on here to talk about these bow tie cigars, man. And speaking of which, look, I know you inside the house tonight, so I don't think you're going to smoke nothing. But I'm down here in the lab. So while we smoking and chopping it up, I'm going to have to smoke one. I was going to fire this old platinum label up, man, but I still ain't had dinner yet.
So yeah, I suggest you put some food on your stomach.
That full body joint right there, we gonna let him rest, man. That's an evening smoke. I'll smoke that one later on, man. But for now, as I sit here in my, hey man, a shout out, man, to the Pouches, man, the Vision, man. You know what I mean? You always doing your thing. You always doing your thing, man. You always adding something to it, you know.
Thank you, brother. You know, just so I know I don't forget to say it, I'm going to say it now. I am inspired in everything that I do by women. And when I say that, what I mean is they take so much time doing everything, making everything beautiful, turning everything into something wonderful, that I just pay attention to what women are doing. And so those pouches were inspired by, you know, by women and how they do certain things. Okay. And so I'm glad that it's translated well across all gender lines. You know, everybody seems to be really taken by the pouches. They're taken to them in a positive way. I've had a couple of mishaps with the pouch like you would with anything else that's brand new and you ain't never had it, and you know, stuff you try to get better the second run, but right. This first run has been received extremely well, and I'm just super happy about that, man.
Well, it's a good look, man, along with the with all the presentation with the cards, man, and the gift wrap, the bow tie
the ribbon
when I got the flags, man. And I didn't take my flags down. I know you probably got one around there somewhere, man. I meant to show off my flags, man. That's a hell of a look, man. Stay hydrated, because I know you lead alcohol to me. You left that alone a while ago.
Yeah It's been 15 years for me on the alcohol, man. But yeah you mentioned the flags. Listen, bro, this is important right here. These will be available very soon on the site. I'm putting a nice little sampler together, and with the sampler pack and the flask shaped water bottle.
Yeah.
Stay hydrated. This is just a reminder to manage the lifestyle. We That's love right. what we do. It makes us happy, et cetera. But I don't care if you smoke cigars or cigarettes or vape or hookah, whatever you do, smoking dehydrates.
That's right.
So this is stylish. It's shaped like something that many of us are used to anyway, a flask if you've ever carried one. So it makes sense to you psychologically. Mm-hmm. And just keep it full of water. Don't put it in the freezer. You're going to crack it. But drink two of these over the course of your night. And maybe you won't wake up at 2:30, 3 in the morning, like my pop used to say with that hot box.
Yeah. Yeah, your chest on fire. You know.
You need some water bad. You know, if you had two of these in you, you might not have that problem right there, man.
Well, that's a true story. Well, hey, man, listen. So we're going to go ahead and smoke. I don't know, can you see that pretty good with that light? But we're going to go ahead and smoke the new one, man, the Couture, the white label by Bowtie, man. First of all, before we get into this cigar, man, let's let the folks know how we met. I'm gonna fire this thing up while we talking, and okay. I'm gonna use my bow tie matches to do it with.
Yeah, yeah, you know they got the logo on the other side too, Playboy.
There it is.
Yeah. Everything got to tie together.
Everything got to tie together. And we'll talk about how we met, and we'll talk about that funky bow tie you got on while we talking about that. This is a true story.
So. We met. Shout out to my homie Ray Ray, bro. If it wasn't for Ray Ray,
that's right.
Then we may not have ever met, and be sitting here this many years later.
That's right, brother. Ray,
shout out to the homie Ray Ray,
one of the original founders, forefathers of the Distinguished Gentleman Cigar Club. That was my pit bull right there. He's still we called him Pit Bull. You know, we had a pit bull and a Rottweiler, him and Roger. You know what I mean?
Oh, yeah, for sure. Ray, shout out to Roger, too. Ray, I haven't talked to him in a long time. Shout out to both of them.
Yeah, man. They doing well, man.
Oh, I'm wonderful. It's glad to hear that, man. That's wonderful. So when I met Ray, we were both working at the same place, man. We was working at the Chrysler factory out in Fenton.
Mm-hmm.
And working in the same department. And he was doing his thing. I was doing mine. We bumped into each other. And at some point, we chopped it up. Start talking about cigars, and I say, well, I've started my own thing. And he was like, you started your own thing, what, a shop? And I was like, a brand, bro. And he was like, you bullshitting. And I was
we good. This is my show. We say what the hell we want on here, man. It's all good. Okay. This is not for kids. We grown men around here.
Wonderful. I just want to make sure I'm being respectful.
Not for kids.
So anyway, he was like, so, yo, you got to let me try those. At the time, I had a private label situation. I brought some of those in, and I can explain the private label in just a second, but I had a situation. And so I brought some of them joints in, and he smoked them and came back and was like, bro, you got to meet my people, man. We got a cigar club called Distinguished Gentlemen. And it went from there.
And that was in 08. Late 08, because when we started the DG thing, it was April of 2009 when we considered ourselves established when we had our very first cigar party.
African Palace, was that at the African Palace, the first joint?
At the African Palace, baby. That's where it all began. That's where the first five or six, seven, eight joints was at the African Palace.
Yeah, that's when I knew I had no idea that you get that cigars was being happening at a restaurant situation like that. That was brand new for me, you know, in North County like that. So that was a good look.
Cigars, food, 2-for-1 drinks.
A whole bunch of great music and a lot of wonderful people and good
weather.
Right.
That's right. It
was a good time.
Good time.
So came to a few of the events and got the opportunity to, y'all like, let me feature you. So we decide we're gonna do that. I'm running late to the event a little bit, not too much, just a little bit, but I stay on the Illinois side of the river. Y'all stay on Missouri. I realized that I left my damn bow tie at the crib and was like, you know what? You looking good, you fly, man. Just go on up in here, man, and do your thing.
Right.
I show up at the venue and all of y'all are standing in there trying to figure out how to tie bow ties. Y'all done went and bought damn bow ties. Y'all done went and bought bow ties for my shit. I was like, oh my God. I had never experienced nothing like that. And I was like, hey, I forgot my tie. Hey, man, it's a K&G across the street. For y'all that don't know, K&G is a department store.
Right.
I ran over there, grabbed the tie, man. We came back. Everybody finally got their ties tied. I had the tie tied too. You might have had the tie tied too because everybody didn't know.
Right.
And we had the event and it was wonderful. That was the beginning. That was the very beginning of how we sitting here right now, man. And it's just amazing that I forgot my damn tie. How dare me name my company after they called myself Bowtie? My name Bowtie and I forgot my damn tie?
We definitely started that bow tie thing around here in St. Louis, man. Every DG event, man, brothers know they had to come correct or don't come at all, man. You know, but when you talk about that, going back to the very beginning when you told Ray Ray about your brand, I'm going to show you something. And I don't know if you even got it.
What's that?
But we want to talk about the original brand, bro.
Oh, shit. Bro. Huh? No, you don't have one of them.
Huh? Who else got one of these, Billy, besides me?
I haven't had one of them since probably 2009.
So how long have I been aging this thing, man?
More than 10 years for sure.
The green label and the blue label. I mean, it wasn't several months ago, I had to smoke that blue label, but I was like, I got to hold on to this, man. I think I might have a green one up there somewhere, man. But this is one of the original bow ties. And this was a 5x50s, weren't they? Robustos, all of them came in that size.
Yeah, bro. I'm tripping off of the band, bro.
man.
That's the original band right there.
That's the original band. And this is where we are now as far as the latest band goes.
Yeah, you know, bro. I mean? Oh, my goodness.
2009, bro.
Hey, do me a favor. Pick up that platinum and put it next to that old school bow tie band itself. I want to see, man, I haven't seen those in forever.
Mm-hmm.
That's when I was so proud of that thing. I'm still proud of it, but I was so proud of that thing right there, bro. That's what you call evolution right there. Mm-hmm. That's evolution.
The original black bow tie.
Yeah. Oh, my goodness. That just made me feel good in my chest, bro. That's a...
You know your boy don't be messing around.
Man, that cigar 10 years old, bro. I hope it smokes 10 years, like it's 10 years, like it's been aged for 10 years, bro. Well, that's a wonderful thing you got there. I don't even have no more of them.
I know you. I said, man, I don't even know if he got no more of these. I might not want to smoke it because of that, but you know, I'm eventually have to burn it because you know some cigars, that's a long time to age a cigar, man. And if you look at this cigar, man, that cigar is still in good shape, bro. You know how I humidify my shit, man. You know what I mean? That thing is ready, man. And it feel like it just came out of the factory, in my opinion.
Well, let me tell you something that y'all probably, I don't know if y'all knew that or not about them cigars, man. Every one of them bands, that's a sticker. I found a company out in Missouri somewhere, down 70.
Mm-hmm.
A little band, a little sticker company. And I sent them over the picture. They turned it into a band. That's actually a sticker. I banded every last one of them cigars myself.
I remember that.
I was still banding cigars back then, man. Yep. It take a long time to ban 2,000 cigars,
bro. Yeah, I remember that, man. He's like, damn, man, I got to get this art out, you know. And if I ain't mistaken, it was the green, the blue, red, and black, right? It was
blue.
Or was it orange?
It was black, it was orange, and it was green.
Okay, not red, blue, orange.
Four different blends, total of 21 sizes, man. You couldn't tell me nothing back then because I went from a dream to having stuff, to having blends. Where yours? I got mine. I know this. Got mine, finally.
And that just let the people know, man, how long you've been in the game. And so many people hadn't heard from you. Those of us around here knew about you. We talk about that journey, man. When you finally got to this particular point, being the originals, these are out of the DR as well. Weren't these out of the DR as well?
Yes, these are out of the DR. Let me step back for just a second, bro, and just share something. Because I don't know if, I know you might have seen me post something before that said, that says 74 times a charm. So you done heard the phrase three times a charm, right? So, you know, for those that may not know, that just means, you know, you try something three times and finally get it right. You failed the first two times.
That's right.
Well, I posted something called 74 Times a Charm.
I remember that.
And what that means is between the middle of 2006 and the end of 2007, I was told no 73 times. I was told no by, not 73 times, I was told no by 73 different cigar companies to work with me.
Right.
And it wasn't 73 phone calls. You can make that in a day. Mm-hmm. I'm talking about wearing these people out, going to events, trying to get somebody to work with me. And I was told no by 73 organizations, 74 times a charm. And when that one came through, I was on vacation with my family in Western Florida and had to drive. It was a company out of Tampa. Had to drive up to Tampa while I was on vacation. Went up there, had the meeting. Shout out to Shanda. Thank you, Miss Shanda. I appreciate you a lot. And she got it. They got it. Mm-hmm. And they decided to work with me after that. And, you know, it was a beautiful, it was one of the most important times in my life. That was a great feeling that day.
Right, right.
But it's just a testament. When you have a dream, ain't nobody going to get it necessarily. But the only person that should give up is, everybody may give up and not believe on you, but you got to do that, bro. That's on you.
That's right.
Don't give up on yourself, man.
That's right. That's right. That's right. So let me ask you this then, Billy.
Standard, man. Huh?
The DR. Your love for cigars and tobacco, was it because you enjoyed a lot of DR cigars? The reason why you chose the DR over, say, Nicaragua, Honduras? Why the DR?
For me, it wasn't a choice of country, because many countries make dope cigars. You know, all of the ones you named, Cuba, Brazil makes some good cigars. You can get some good ones in Europe. There. For me, it was the correct fit, the correct relationship. At the, you know, a minute ago, we were just talking about how we met through, you know, Ray Ray introduced us, and bam, here we are more than 10 years later having this conversation.
Right.
I couldn't find the correct relationship. So I said, put out a phone, out of business in a phone call. I went to place a phone call with the company I was talking about. They were no longer going to do any more private labeling at all for anybody. So I go to place an order before Thanksgiving, and they're like, Mr. King, we're not doing that anymore. It was a business decision. So I'm done. That was it.
Right. I remember that.
I decided to go to, I scraped up my little money, man. And in 2010, this was 2009. In 2010, I scraped up my little money and bought the entire weekend at the Big Smoke in Vegas. Because right. I was like, one way or the other, I got to go meet some people.
Right.
I got to figure this out. I don't want another private label deal. It was a blessing.
Right.
I want a factory, but it's got to be the right situation.
Mm-hmm.
While I was at that event, I ran into, I met Sam Lucia. At the time, working with Oliva. And a great guy, man. And we ended up chopping it up, exchanging information. And I'm a prideful man. My father is always, you know, you go get it on your own. You don't ask for nothing. You go get it. But I broke down and made the call, bro. And Sam said, hey, I got a factory that if it works out for you, cool. And from the moment that I met the Cuevas family, and I knew Sam's palate, and expertise, he really understands cigars a lot.
Sam's a dad, right? Sam's a dad, and Luis is
no. Sam Lucia.
Sam Lucia.
Yeah. Lucia owns Stogie Bird, Lucia Tobacco. He used to be with Oliva.
Okay.
And this guy, when I tell you, he's got one of the most developed cigar palates of anybody I've ever met. I mean that, like I would hope to have that kind of developed palate one day. That guy is really good. So anyway, he introduced me. We make the phone call. I fly down to Miami. They meet me in Miami. Then we go over to the Dominican. From the moment that I sat down and started working, talking to these folks, I knew that the situation was right. The energy made sense to me.
Mm-hmm.
So from there, it was a great relationship. And then I I find out that at the time, the master blender not only is the owner, but he's been there for 40-something years blending. Got 40-something years experience. You talk about a happy moment for your boy. So it had less to do with the country, more to do with the relationship. And they believed in me through all of these ups and downs. And they still believing in me. We still working together. And now it's my time to go ahead and start putting some numbers on the board so that I can reintroduce my brand for what I've been working on for the last 10 years in the way that I want to do it. It's beautiful. It's wonderful, man. I'm blessed.
Right. That's right, man. I seen an interview not long ago with Luis Cuevas on there, man, and he was asked the questions, who do we miss working with? And he mentioned you. Buddy, matter of fact, I had saw that, and then Lee Mack came to me and said, man, have you seen this? And I said, that's the guy that Billy was telling me about, man. So the feeling was mutual between you guys, man. From what I understand, they're doing their own cigars now, man, and I'm glad you had that relationship with them, because it was a journey, but it's turned out to be a good one, man. This Couture White Label smoking good again. Look at that.
Yeah, man. That
burn line, Couture, man. And I remember when I asked you a couple weeks ago when I reviewed this thing, I said, am I crazy, man? But am I getting some mint in this thing, like some chocolate mint, some type of a mint flavor? You know, man, I know you're always talking about my palate, man, but that chocolate mint, it's there. And it's one of the, it's that taste that I can't get out of my mouth when I'm smoking this cigar, man.
Yeah, one of the beautiful things about that cigar right there is it was stumbled upon on the way to a different blend. So I had gone over there and we were working on the full label. A full body, full strength stick. I was chasing the platinum. I knew what I wanted it to taste like. And so there's a process of how you get to a blend. And it starts at a point, and then you, in an iterative process, you add, you take away from it, and then you smoke. And you add, you take away from it, then you smoke. And you keep doing that until it tastes like what you taste in your mind. That's what works for me, because I'm not a blender.
Right.
As we're going through that process, this cigar presented itself in those steps. I knew that it was delicious. I knew I liked it when we got to it, but it was a medium body, a medium strength stick. Mm-hmm. I wasn't ready. I already had the copper label. So I didn't need another medium. I had to get a full in the lineup. Mild, medium, and full was my goal. And then I would start doing other stuff. So that's the reason that this one came out fourth. Copper first, platinum second, 314 red third, and now this one.
Right.
But I had him roll me up some of those. The shape was all his idea, because, you know, all mine are just the traditional
Toro
shape.
Size. Yeah.
And so he convinced me to do that. He rolled them up, and they sat there on the shelf all those years until it was time. And so this is the
How
time.
How long was that? About five years, they said?
5 years. The last time I've been over there was 5 years ago. So them sat up for 5 years.
They ready, man. I mean, it's a wonderful stick, man. I truly, truly enjoy it, man. I can't wait till the other couple of fellas get their hands on it, man, so they can tell you what they think, man. This ain't no bullshit. Like I said, I know this man, and I know the journey, because I've been with him along the way, man. Wait, as much as he's been waiting to put the cigar together, we've been waiting to smoke it, man. So pretty work on that, bro.
Thank you, my man. I appreciate that, man.
So let me ask you this here real quick. Speaking of the brands, the cigars. So we got the 314, we've got the copper, we've got the
platinum,
we've got the new Couture White Label, and then there are what I was telling people, the Naked Beauties, which I'm seeing a lot of people. I'm involved with a couple of cigar clubs now, and they calling them factory farm rolls, this, that, and the other. And I've been knowing that this ain't something that just came about in the last couple of years. You have been dealing with factory farm rolls with us, I know, for the past 5 or 6 years with some of the events that we've been giving. You call them the Naked Beauties with no bands on them.
Yes, sir. One of the things that I realized in dealing with Las Lavas, that's the name of the factory over in the DR. mm-hmm. and dealing with that family. And you know, I've got an engineering degree by, you know, I'm a degreed engineer, and I practiced that in a factory environment my entire career, more than 20 years. Right. And my specialty is quality, right? I can walk into anybody's factory and tell you it'll make sense to me. I don't care if you're making cigars or automobiles or ammunition or paper clips. It don't matter. I know what it's supposed to look like, feel like.
Right.
When I tell you I walked into that factory and I was blown away at how it's run, I was blown away at the quality that they build into it, the testing, how they store, everything, all of it. So when I saw that, how can a cigar be bad or second rate when it's made in a factory that is run properly, that has quality, and the person that's running it has more than 40 years worth of blending experience? It's a good blend.
Yeah, it's a no-brainer.
Anything they put out is a good blend. Mm. So what I realized is that it costs so much money to put a cigar out, to market it, to do all of the things you got to do. You got to make hard choices. So maybe when they looked at these three that are delicious, these three blends, and versus the cost of doing it instead of the Casa Cuevas, it made more sense to just leave these naked. But they're still delicious. They were still created by the same master blender that I love working with. I love working with these folks, bro. Oh my goodness.
The Connecticut, wonderful. Habano, and Maduro.
And Maduro. And they're, you know, all delicious, man.
You know, I love that Habano, man. You remember I called you that night? I was smoking that Habano and I just kept running it off to you. It was like, bro, you killing me with these flavors, but you so right. Great cigar, man.
Yeah. So I asked them for permission to be able to add that to my lineup. And so they said, sure, we'll be more than happy to do it. We came up with a deal, you know, how that's structured. And I've been, you know, taking advantage of that. So I operate inside win-win situations. I don't just say that. Everybody that's worked with me, whether it's been on a cigar tip or, you know, all the photo shoots and stuff I do, or if I'm working on somebody else's team, it has to be a win-win situation.
Right.
And it's a win-win. And I can't speak for anybody else in St. Louis because I don't know what the other brands are doing. I'm focused solely on what I'm doing. But I have four bow-tie blended, bow-tie labeled cigars, and I have three Naked Beauties. So what am I just saying? If you do the math, I have seven different blends to offer on my website to the audience that I'm building over time. That's seven. I don't know if anybody else has seven. I hope they do, but I got seven. And that's what the, when you take your time and do things quietly, slowly, with intention, even when people think you're not working, then you like, bam, seven. He got seven blends. He got seven things to choose from.
Right.
And so that's where that came from, man. Yeah. I recognized a long time ago the value in a naked cigar, man. They, especially when you got a master making it. It's like a Dr. Dre beat. I don't care if it didn't make the album, it's still a Dr. Dre beat.
Right. I call them mystery sticks, man. Any of those cigars that don't come with the label, I call them mystery sticks, man. They don't have anything to tell you. You have to tell that story when you smoke that cigar.
Man, that's a wonderful way to look at that right there too, bro. Good. That's beautiful, you know, right there. Don't lose that.
Yeah. You know, nobody told you what was in it. Nobody told you anything about it. Now, if you really about your shit, you ought to be able to smoke that cigar and tell me what's up with it. So that's what the Naked Beauties do for me, those cigars that come like that, man. You know, when I'm dealing with the farm rolls, and definitely yours, man. So look, what do you say to people when they tell you got too much band on that cigar, bro? When I tell them we ain't smoking the band, but what do you say?
So it's a love it or hate it situation with the band. Okay. I know, because I know everybody doesn't like a big band, and that's fine. Just to give you a quick story, a quick history. The Copper Label was my reintroduction after I got a factory situation to the industry, especially to St. Louis. I always say St. Louis because I believe in getting your backyard. One of the St. Lunatics, Murphy Lee, I heard him interview one time, and some kid called into the radio station and said, "What do you suggest to getting there, to getting success?" He said, "Get your backyard, man. If you can get your backyard, you can get anybody's backyard." I never forgot that. I never, ever forgot that. And so what I do in most cases is for the St. Louis area because it's my backyard, bro. Like, if I can win y'all, I can win anybody. Copper Label came out, and then the Platinum Label. If you notice, the band on those two cigars are very standardized.
Right.
That was to let the world know, this is me.
That's right.
314, I'm paying homage to the city that's been holding me down. Like, who doesn't do that?
Right.
So 314, if you don't know, for those listening, is the area code in St. Louis. If you, now y'all know I'm from the Chicagoland area, all the team, all my teams that I follow, it's going to be Chicago. But if you look at the colors on that band, those are the Cardinals colors. Even down to that powder blue uniform is on that band, that powder blue color. That was my homage. Couture. The couture is, so I've standardized, I've paid homage to the city that's been holding me down. Couture is kind of like that fourth album that some artists make, and it's just for them.
Yeah.
They don't give a damn. It's a love it or hate it.
Right.
So all of that band, all of that ostentatious, everything, even the name Couture, which if you look that up, it has to do with one of a kinds. It has to do with handmade. It has to do with the best qualities. This is me presenting myself in the way that I see myself. You know, I'm a little loud with the way I do stuff.
Right.
But it's also a shout out to Las Lavas, to that Cuevas family, because they do everything at such a high level. It's me saying, yo, this is the absolute best of the best. You may love it. You may not love it. But it does not mean that the qualities that went into that cigar, the materials, the workmanship, everything is at the highest level.
That's right.
I say to them, love it or hate it, I would hope that you would get to a place along your journey where you can do a project that ain't about nobody else. It's just about you.
That's what this is,
this
man.
This cigar is just about me.
That's right. Love it or hate it. That's right. So, we talked about the Copper Label, which, you know, that made my my list for 2020 as one of my go-to cigars that I will always have in my box. I say the Copper Label changed the game for bowtie cigars, and now this White Label has come in to keep you in the game. That's how I see it when I'm smoking them.
Yeah, the Copper Label, the origin of that cigar, I went over there to blend. I had 2 days in the Dominican. It was my very first time going over there. I had spent all the money I could spend. There was no more in the coffers, bro. None. So I get over there. We're in the factory for 2 days. And I had a very simplistic idea, but I knew what it wanted to taste like. I know exactly what I wanted it to taste like. 7 tobaccos in 5 different countries and 14 cigars later, over the course of 2 days, smoked almost 14 cigars. Copper Label was born, and I knew that it was going to be a really special stick. It's complex as hell.
Yeah,
everybody is not going to get it, but no. That's the most complex cigar in my lineup, and that's just what it is, period.
Right.
And I would never suggest anybody smoke 14 cigars in 2 days. That's just a bad idea. That's a bad idea, hey, man. That's
you say that, but I know a couple brothers, they doing that right now, man. I don't know how they do it, man.
God, bro, you talk about feel like you've been in a fight. And I got home. I got back to the hotel that first night. First thing I did was shower, and I went and got on the treadmill for about 35, 40 minutes and about died trying to get that smoke about.
Oh, man.
Out again, and got ready to get something to eat, and went to bed, and got up and did it the next day. But it took that long. It took that much time in order to get to that copper label, man. And I pray I don't ever have to do that again. But I had laid it all on the table, man. There was no more money. Right. I didn't know if this thing was going to go any further. Right. And it just go to show you how God bless you, bro.
Yeah. Yeah.
It just go to show you how he bless you when you asking for something and he made it happen.
And you gotta have patience, man. Gotta have patience. Yeah. So hats off to you for that, brother. Salute to you.
Oh,
hey,
let me ask you this.
And I'll say this after. I remember when we came out this whole bow tie thing. I don't know if you remember me a few years back. I called you or either I sent you a message. I said, hey man, it's some motherfucker out there trying to use a bow tie on a cigar as a label. Do you remember this conversation?
Yeah, I do. And
I can't remember what cigar that was, but I saw that, man, and I wanted to go do a drive-by on this. Whoever this person was, wherever they was, I'm like, you ain't going to be able to do that. So my question is, why the bow tie? There's so many people out there that think, damn, I wish I'd have thought of that.
Okay. So I was introduced to the bow tie by my father-in-law. He wears bow ties all the time. That's kind of his thing. I remember as a kid, my father would wear one sometimes too, right? Anyway, I started wearing these bow ties and I fell in love with it to the point that I gave my father all of my straight ties. I don't own a straight tie. I've not owned a straight tie in probably 12 years. It's been a long time.
Mm-hmm.
The reason that I chose it, the reason that I chose the name and all of that, the name of the company, my name, bow tie, you know, talk about myself in the third person like you be doing sometimes. That
shit's
funny.
Yeah, I do that a lot. I have to be told that I do that. I don't even realize I'm doing it.
I don't either. Be like, bow tie, what, how you going to do this, right? You know, I do that. I do that all the time. So anyway, but to me personally, if you think about it, a tie is a singular strip of material cut into a shape. And you knot it into something that is not only has a purpose, it, you know, there's a utility purpose to it, but it's beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
A tie is a personality. The way I was told a long time ago, stop worrying about how your tie looked that day. Your tie is tied to how you feel in that day, your bow tie, the way that knot looked. Them wings is gonna look how you feel that day. Embrace it. So it's layered. It's like a personality that of a person. And so it's a strong knot. Once you get your knot there, it's not coming loose unless you're messing with it.
Right.
It comes in all patterns. All materials can be made out of it. Although I don't use clip-ons and that kind of thing, self-tap. I don't do none of those, but
no.
They exist.
Yeah.
And it's just a complex, beautiful, strong, well thought out design, people are, like cigars are, real long filler premium 50 year blender, master blenders. Those are projects that last a lifetime. No different than that black label you just talked about. You done had it for more than 10 years for sure.
Yeah.
It's a piece of art.
Yeah.
So to me, what better way to represent my brand and myself then by naming it after something that I had so much love for. Even I had love for the bow tie before I had love for cigars.
Right.
I did. So yeah. That's where that comes from. It's like the best of the best of the best. Even on your worst day, somebody will say, may say, well, that bow tie he had on was popping, although that was terrible.
Right.
He was looking good while, you know what I'm saying?
Well, you know, you remember at the DG events, man, we'd be dressed in our bow ties, man. And we would walk around, you'd be like, hey, it's like, damn, bro, your knot, man, your knot is tight. Your knot is tight. We all had our own knot. We had to get some of these guys to understand when they was talking about, man, I can't tie a bow tie. We would tie some of the bow ties for them. We say, hey, bro, once you get this figured out, your knot is your knot. Your knot gonna not, it's not going to look like mine.
Not at all. And I think that's one of the wonderful things about cigars is we may not like the same stick. It does not mean that that stick is not good.
That's right.
What you're doing with your podcast one of the reasons that I like it as much as I do, outside of the fact that we're family and I love you.
Right.
But I'm going to always look for authenticity. The way that you go about cigars is it's an authentic conversational approach that somebody that has $20 to spend can say, my man liked it. I believe him. Even though I may not like it when I try it, he's earned my respect. It's authentic.
Yeah.
And so for me, I always look for that. It doesn't matter if it's Cowboy Podcast, a DG Podcast, or Sam Lucia doing what he do. It doesn't matter. None of that matters.
Right.
All that matters to me is I'm going to read you. And if it's authentic, that you talked about a Lancero in that list that you did.
The Luciano, the Dreamer, baby.
I want to try that based on you. Yeah. That ain't based on nothing else. That's based on the authenticity. And you talked about a bunch of cigars, including mine.
Right.
But I want to try that one.
Right.
Based on the authenticity that went into how you talked about it. That's good enough for me.
Right, 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 right. Right.
You know what I'm saying? So that's why the bow tie. The bow tie to me is an authentic. You can wear a bow tie and a pair of gym shoes. You can wear a bow tie with a tuxedo and everything in between. So isn't that us as people?
That's us, man. 100%.
That's us as people. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? So that's why I chose it, embrace it, and it's mine. It's the way that I roll, and love it or hate it. Like right. That big ass band you got on that cigar.
Yeah. I'm gonna smoke it down to the band. I like to say we ain't gonna smoke the band, but I love it. I like to say the cigar is dressed for the occasion. It's dressed like a tuxedo, baby. So yeah, I love it, man. It's truly you, man. It's that art in you, man. You know,
yeah,
your photography. A lot of people don't know, man. I'm gonna speak on this real quick. We've been on now about 45 minutes. We'll see if we can get about another 10 minutes out of here so I don't wear my people out when I do get this up.
Okay.
But I remember the site when the site first became available some years ago. It was around the time.
The new one or the old one? Okay.
You remember the old site?
Yeah.
DG, we had a site at one time that was hot. Had all our parties and pictures, and it got hacked. We lost it. We never did it again. So the old site was what it was. People won't know what that was now. But you shut that site down after a while. Number one, the cigars became an issue getting them in. But when you went back this time to revamp the site, what made you change the site from what it was?
Evolution. The first site was I designed every page on that site. That was before you could Shopify's and all of these different templates existed that are just wonderful. I had to pay somebody. That site cost me about $3,500 for that site. So I designed it on paper. I took it to one of the same companies that works with companies like Nike and all of them, you know, real large accounts. I had them make the site for me and I put it up. And at the time it went up, it was cutting edge, period. That's just what it was.
Right.
But it was all about cigars. I've evolved since then. I've realized that Bowtie is a brand. Bowtie Cigars is how it started. My current site is like the universe that I'm building of all of the things that I love that make me me. And there are some people that can appreciate what you do, just the way you do it. No different than me going out and buying a pair of Chuck Taylors. Everybody don't like Chucks. I own almost 30 pairs of Chucks, bro. I love Chucks.
Yeah, me too.
So in building my brand as a whole, the major goal is to be able to put that bow tie on whatever I want to put it on. So you'll be able to buy t-shirts and some clothing items on there. You'll be able to buy jewelry on there soon. Guillermo Reyes is the name of my jewelry collection. I've been making custom jewelry for more than 10 years.
Right.
I'm working with a company now that's going to start manufacturing all my designs for me. Those are coming out in 2021. Accessories like luggage tags and cutters and whatever makes sense to me. You know, I showed you guys the flask before. It says Bowtie Cigar on it, but I've never heard of a cigar company with a water bottle. I've never heard of that before.
Right.
That's my thing.
Right.
And then there's obviously the lookbook and all of the imagery from just in general. There's the blog page, which is going to be a lot of the photo shoots. And then there's a page on there dedicated to artists. And working with all these beautiful, talented people, I wanted to give them a look. So all of the artists that I've reached out to, you'll start seeing those go up every 2 to 3 weeks, a different artist, and I'll give them that platform and I'll help push them. And I don't care if they do paintings or music or they dance or graphic art, whatever they do. Whatever they do, it is my responsibility. I created this platform to help you too. That's what that page is for. Mm-hmm. So the site now is an evolution of me. It's my evolution. It's a representation of that, my universe. And I'm going to do it that way. As I say, I contribute to cigar culture my way. I put that on a whole bunch of stuff.
Right, right.
That's what I mean.
The site is nice, man. I mean, I love what you've done to it. And once people go to it, I know you're still working on some things, man. To see all your beautiful models up there, man, that have been working with you for so long, man, and your photography, man, hats off to you for that. People are really going to enjoy what they see on the site. I think for you guys that have not seen that site yet, bowtiecigar.com. Before we get off of here, we'll let Billy give you guys some more information on how to get in touch with him and how to contact him and all of his other social media platforms, man. But it really is a nice looking site, unlike any other cigar site out there, for sure.
Absolutely. Thank you for that. I appreciate it. One of the things that I noticed is within the cigar industry is that everybody kind of has their thing. One of the people that stand out the most to me is Pete Johnson that owns Tatuaje. The way that he markets himself is unlike anybody else.
Yeah, I agree.
Period. And it's beautiful and it matches him.
Right.
I can't do what the Fuentes family do. I'm from North Chicago, Illinois, man. We don't know cigar factories and farms. So other than a shoot, I would look ridiculous out here trying to look like them with a wire batter and the hat. And I'm standing in a factory. It's not authentic, man. It's right. Not me. That's not them. It works for them, though.
Right, right.
So, the site again, bowtiecigar.com. Instagram, Bowtie Cigars with an S. Same thing on Facebook. For whatever reason, my Twitter account, they suspended it. I don't know what happened, but it got suspended. I don't know. I haven't been on Twitter in a long time anyway.
Right.
And to reach out to me, there's the contact us on that page. You can hit me on any one of my social media platforms. Give the cigars a try, man. I've curated a number of things to go together so that cigar smoking time is a total experience. From the look of the pouch to the cigars themselves and the way that they're dressed to the, you know, the custom cutters and stuff all match everything else. Right. To everything is to spark a conversation, bro, like we're having now. Right. And so you got everything you need, not only that go together, but to spark a conversation, maybe with the person sitting next to you, and that person could turn out to be a lifelong friend because they looked over and said, man, what is that? Or your lady for life, because she looked over and said, that bag is cute. Mm-hmm. Now, Bowtie has done his work. I did my work in that case and got you the look.
Right.
If you can't close it, like Leon Phelps said, if you can't close the deal after that, homie,
it ain't my fault. It ain't my fault.
But, you know, I threw it out there to get you to know, for her to notice you.
Yeah.
I did my job.
It's a beautiful conversation piece, man. So, hey, man, before we wrap this up, man, what's your vision? Bowtie, what do you see Bowtie in the next 5 years? We know from which we come, and now that it looks like things are going in the right direction now, 2020 has been one hell of a year, crazy, but it's been a great year, in my opinion, for the cigar community, man. It's been a great year for cigars. Where do you see Bowtie in the next 5 years? What's your vision?
Very simply, much greater numbers. The correct distribution deal. I've turned down 3 different distribution deals over the course of the last few years. They didn't make sense to me. None of them made sense. Mm-hmm. The correct distribution deal. It took me since 2013 to get the blends that I have. My goal is 10 that have bow ties on them, 10 blends that are actively selling that are mine.
Right.
And then to continue developing the site in general, my universe in general, so that at any point, at some point in the future, at the end of that 5 years, I can put my logo on whatever the hell I want to put my logo on, from cigars to linens to clothing to whatever. That is the goal. I'm really trying to build an overall brand, and cigars has just been a wonderful privilege as the vehicle that I've chosen in order to get that bow tie and what I'm doing to the masses. It's an honor, bro. It's a real honor, man.
Well, that's good, man. You know I'm riding with you, ride or die. You already know that, man. We talk about branding all the time, man, and branding is exactly what you've done. You know, I know about branding for myself. I just simply do me. I'm not gonna try to be anyone else, man. We just gonna keep our foot on the gas, man, and we're gonna keep rolling, man.
Absolutely. You know?
We're gonna keep this thing rolling. It's your time, man, and I'm hopeful that the folk that are out there, my over 400 subscribers that are watching right now, shout out to y'all, shout out to the Army. Y'all know I love y'all, man. Go check my man Bowtie out. Give it a chance, man. Like I said before, I shouldn't have to say it's a black-owned company, but I must say that because we have to pat ourselves on the back, you know, because it was a time when we was told there were some things that we just could not do.
Absolutely.
It's bullshit. We can do anything that we put our minds to because we've been doing it all the time anyway. So with that said, man, we're going to cut this thing off, man. If there's anything else that you'd like to say to the people before we go, speak it on it now.
Yeah, just I want to thank you, bro, for this. I'm super proud of you. I appreciate this opportunity. And strictly for St. Louis, this is my opinion, for the St. Louis Metro East area, the Distinguished Gentlemen Cigar Club, I thank all of you guys, all of you guys. Y'all wrote the book on cigar stuff in St. Louis when it come down to these parties and whatnot, period. It did not exist. It did not. I can honestly say I know that I had an effect on the wearing the bow ties in St. Louis at the cigar stuff, but when it come down to these cigar parties, that's y'all, bro. Anything that we see happening now is beautiful. I love it. I love to see it because it pushes the culture forward. But that's in right. St. Louis, that's y'all, all of y'all. So I just want to say thank you to each and every one of y'all for embracing me, for allowing me to stand on y'all platform, and then just the brotherhood that came out of all of that. I have some lifelong friends because of this stuff we're doing and because of that club that y'all put together, man. So thank you from the bottom of my heart. I can't thank you enough for that. All of y'all.
But you know, we appreciate you, man. Myself, Cowboy, my Ace Bone Cone, my right hand man, Big Tim, Lil Henry, Old Henry the Candy Boy, my man Murph, Nephew Kev, Ray Ray, Roger. And, you know, we've had a few guys come and go, man, but we still strong. I don't get a chance to kick it with my brothers like I used to. You know, it is what it is. It's the time that we're in. But that's my family, man. You know that. And we all started together. We're going to ride together, man. DG for life, baby. Whole life.
Absolutely, bro. Hey, man, so I love you, man. Thank you again for this opportunity. And, you know, let's chop it up and see how to move some things forward that, aside from what we're doing right this minute, I know we've got some ideas. Let's talk about those things off camera, bro, and get this thing moving in 2021. It's about to be a different year.
All right. Well, my cigar smoking family, as I promised, man, I got Mr. Bowtie on, and we've chopped it up. We've chatted. We could go on and on, but we know we can't keep this thing going too long. So from Mr. Bowtie himself and from Cowboy, that's my take on it. Y'all enjoy the rest of your day. We out of here. Peace.
Thank you, brother.
I'll holler at you, bro. Love you.
Love you back.